Wanna play some shitty mediocre Mario hacks? This hack is unspeakably ass. Alright, all you hackers, it's 2015, a brand new year full of brand new promises, and to start things off, I'm gonna give y'all a little treat. This is the review you all want to see, Hammer Brother. Now, I've been told that this hack is horrible, and I'm not kidding, I'm not exaggerating one bit when I say the requests for it have been up the ass. I'm talking more than that other hack that starts with C and ends with AOS Complex. Yeah, that much. And it's been making me seriously doubt. How bad could it really be? Can it really be as bad as they say it is? Well, today, right here, right now, we're gonna find out. For better or worse, I'm going in.
Now, first things first, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about a friendly fellow named Blackout77. He joined the Central in 2013, made one post, posted two hacks, and was never heard from again. The first of those hacks was called Super Mario Collision. It had shitty graphics, horrible music, unedited overworlds. In other words, it was a godforsaken piece of fuck! This hack is also high in the unfairness factor. Look at this, if you're Big Mario and you happen to jump anywhere near here by mistake, you die instantly. That's fucking bullshit!
But alright, enough with that. I think we all know here that the hack you really want to see is his second, the infamous Hammer Brother. Now, as I've said, this hack has been getting loads of attention lately because of how bad it is, and in fact, I've even heard it being thrown around that this is the worst hack of all time. In fact, when I first mentioned that I was going to review this hack, the first reaction I got was from my good friend Level Engine, and this is what he said. Yeah, have fun with the worst hack in the world. Believe me, bad doesn't even describe it. Now you know me. I've played a lot of shit, but those are some harsh words. I mean, how could one game possibly warrant that kind of talk? I mean, worse than Patsy? Worse than Adventure of the Red Plumber? That's not possible. How could it be possible?
That can't be. I try to slide under this robot head thing, and yet I die? How does that happen? Look how much space. Look how much space is under there. What did I hit? I touched nothing! So why is this happening? Well, you're not going to believe it, but this is actually a Rex. The same two square hitbox is still there. In fact, if you toss a shell under it, that kills it too. This is too fucked up. This one enemy defies every iota of knowledge in the human brain! Now get a load of this. Not 10 seconds later, you have to ride a Mega Mole over spikes. Then another one of those things starts coming, and unless you have the ninjutsu reflexes to jump on it twice and make it back to the mole in time, it flips the mole around, and then your fate has been sealed. The screen doesn't scroll back in this stage, so when the mole leaves, you fall to your death. I've tried and I've tried, but I cannot pass this part. And the saddest thing is, I'm only about a minute into the game. It's time to try another stage. But first, I should mention the menu level, this hack's version of Yoshi's House. See? You? Item? I take it back. I don't know what to say. You've gotta love that overworld sprite, too. Nothing grants more satisfaction to a gamer than playing as a deformed turtle with a head big enough to crush the entire rest of its body. So here's the other level you can play at the start of the game, Broken Streets. Well, for starters, that background sure is appealing. It has all the beauty of a mountain lion's hairy asshole covered in vomit from a giant radioactive Martian alpaca. What a thing of beauty. I'd set this as my desktop wallpaper. I'd get it stitched onto my pillows. For God's sakes, I'd put this everywhere. As for the stage, well, I guess I'm on some kind of city street. We've got a few Goombas, but that's about— Fuck! Why would they put that there? They knew you'd jump right into it. It's like a trick. Like someone's just sitting there laughing his ass off as you fall to your doom.
Ooh, he fell for it!
Well, this time I know it's there. I'm gonna hit it. I'm gonna move on. Oh, where is it? Oh, mother of a fuck! Okay, well, it didn't get me this time. Moving on. Wait, what's in that block? I'm going down there. Coins? Okay, well then— ah, shit, in my fucking Goombas?! Well, at the end of the stage, you fight the first boss, and it's one of the weirdest I've ever seen. It's two crystals that bounce off the walls. You've gotta hit him with these hard hats? I don't really get it. Alright, got one. Now it's time for him. What? The hard hat didn't work? It didn't work? That's horse shit! How come it killed the last one, but went right through that one? Well, I figured out what the deal is, and you're not gonna believe it. Only this hard hat will kill the blue one, and only this one will kill the green one. Why did they do this to us? That's not easy to figure out. The hats look exactly the same! If you can't tell the difference, you're doomed, let alone if one of the hats gets destroyed. And when you're about to beat the boss, in the name of all that is holy, do not be anywhere near the bottom of the screen. This hole is the product of the devil. This is the hole that leads to hell! It's the most unfair kind of trap that could ever have possibly been put into this hack! Unless you're far away from that hole, your victory march will take you straight down, and there isn't a damn thing under the sun that you can do. It's like a cruel prank. After all you've been through already in this stage, and if you don't realize what's coming, it's all for nothing. You die, you go back. The next stage is called Frustration Redo. That doesn't sound especially promising, but let's give it a try. What?
Fuck rat, you scum!
It's a beginner's trap. Either you know what's coming, or you die. In this case, you have to be holding B as soon as the level begins to bounce off this enemy, or else you'll fall into the water. You're essentially guaranteed to lose one life. So, try two. We're moving on. No! No! Are you shitting me? The same fucking trick, more invisible blocks!
Invis-a-bitch!
Long story short, the name does not lie. This level frustrates you to no end. And they put that same bullshit from the first stage. The screen only scrolls forward. If you get to some place and find out you needed to bring something with you, you can't go back for it. You don't get another try. All you can do is commit suicide and go all the way back. Yeah, that's the redo part. Aw, ass, I wasn't holding A!
Bullfuck! Bullfuck!
Next up is level 3, enemy aircrafts. This is where that one-way gimmick will make you want to kill every human being on the planet Earth. Whenever there are multiple paths, if you go the wrong way, it's a dead end. And your choices now are to jump off that cliff or run the timer out. Basically, whichever way you prefer to die, because that's all you can do. Commit suicide. Why does this game have to be so harsh? All I did was pick the wrong path. How was I supposed to know which way I needed to go? Does the punishment fit the crime? Does that really have to cost me a life? That invisible barrier that stops the screen from scrolling is just like one giant invisible middle finger that's constantly flipping you off. Missed the enemy? Fuck you. Didn't bring a shell? Fuck you. Went the wrong fucking way? Fuck you, dick fart. I've also been noticing that there aren't any power-ups in this entire game. If anything so much as touches you, you die! Now, what the hell is this? What's going on here? I'm throwing another hammer, bro, at a bunch of sliced onions? Why am I doing that? I know you all were the ones who wanted me to play this so badly, so you probably already know this, but this hack is horrific! It's fucking garbage! And I've only played the first few stages! But would you ever believe me if I told you it gets worse? Well, somehow, against every known law of logic and common sense, it does. You get to this stadium level, and every door and every exit you find will just lead back to the beginning. And you never realize that's where you're headed until it's too late. And wouldn't you know, you can't go back! You're going to see this one image over and over again. It will be burned into your monitor screen. And your mind. Eventually, you'll make it to this part where every one of these gray blocks is a ledge. When you go up, you can't come back down. So to get through here, you just have to wait for the damn robot heads! Come on, you sons of asses! Move! And what do I find? Well, there's that door up there, but there's no way to get to it. It just taunts you. There's another one, but it just leads back to the start again! I feel like I'm lost in a maze with no end, and I'm being completely honest when I tell you that I've tried everything. I found a few things that I swear are supposed to be important, like this block, but that doesn't do jack shit. There's also this vine that you hit with a shell, but that just takes you back to the part with the robot heads. I've literally done all I can, but I can't go any further. So I have no choice but to stop.
Blackout 77, you scrub. Well, suffice it to say that this hack just sucks. And I never thought it'd be nearly as horrible as people said it was, but no, it's not just bad. It's obscenely bad, and its very existence leaves me feeling raped. Well, all that aside, there's one question that remains to be asked, and that is this really the worst? Well, I've thought long and hard about that, and the answer is, it's really not. It's cryptic, it's frustrating, but in the end, it doesn't come close to some other hacks I've played. What makes the difference is that it's playable. Up to a point, maybe, but that matters. A whole lot. I just guess the truth of the matter is, we all love to hate. We all need something to smash on, whatever it may be, just as much as we need great hacks to love and cherish. We need something to compare our work against, to know that no matter how much we may think our hack sucks, it's nowhere near real trash. And right now, Hammer Brother is the perfect butt monkey. But if you want to hear about the real worst hack of all time, well, there's a prophecy about that one. What, you've never heard it? Well, it goes something like this.
Two X's at the end of its cursed name, seven grammatical errors and its mind-wrenching start. One creator, a hacker of wonderful fame, makes a hack that stinks worse than a dung beetle's fart. One shitty hack to rule them all, one hack to find them, one hack to fuck them, and in the assness bind them in the land of the central where the shit stains lie.
Invisibitch!